Hello, my Alphas members and Twitch watchers to How to German episode 7. Before we go to the main thing, let me first introduce everybody what exactly How to German is. Well, How to German is my little stream series where you can learn some German while I refresh my own German. And yeah, even though the service that I use, being Duolingo, have sadly some problems if it comes from English to German translation, but don't worry, I'm here, I can give you some explanations, tips, whatever, to have some good German. And also, if you missed the previous episodes, don't worry. On Twitch, there's always the collection titled How to German, where all the previous episodes are in, and you can enjoy them completely within way, completely through, because those are highlights. With other words, there are no breaks in those highlights. So, yeah. So, without further ado, let's begin our first lesson of the day, birthday. So,
was machst du morgen?
What are you doing tomorrow? Also, another thing is, also, Billigon. The text-to-speech is weird on this side. Also, I'm not sponsored by Duolingo, just saying.
Wann hast du Geburtstag?
When is your birthday?
Hast du morgen Geburtstag? Hast du morgen Geburtstag?
Is tomorrow your birthday? Is your birthday tomorrow?
Wer hat heute Geburtstag?
Whose birthday is today?
Ich habe morgen Geburtstag.
My birthday is tomorrow. I'm impressed
Hast
here.
Du heute Geburtstag?
Is your birthday today? Hast du heute Geburtstag?
Meine Lehrerin hat im April Geburtstag.
My teacher birthday is in April.
Ich habe am Montag Geburtstag.
My birthday is on Monday.
Möchtest du morgen Apfelkuchen mit Eis essen?
You want to eat apple pie with ice cream? I mean, that sounds good actually. Möchtest du morgen Apfelkuchen mit Eis essen? Would you like to eat apple pie? Cake. It's not cake, it's pie. It's actually. Yeah, if you translate
Apfelkuchen
one to one, then it's apple cake, but it's technically also apple pie.
Mein Onkel hat am 1. März Geburtstag.
My uncle's birthday is on the 1st of March.
Ich habe im April Geburtstag.
My birthday is in April. Ich habe im April Geburtstag.
Was machst du am 1. März?
What are you doing on the 1st of March?
Mein Hund hat im April Geburtstag.
My dog's birthday is in April. Mein Hund hat im April Geburtstag.
Hast du am 1. März Geburtstag?
Is your birthday on the 1st of March? Or March 1st? Hast du am 1. März Geburtstag?
Ich habe heute Geburtstag.
Today is my birthday. Ich habe heute Geburtstag. Okay, hard mode, aka from English to German. My mother's birthday is on the 1st of March.
Meine Mutter hat am 1. April
No.
März Geburtstag.
My dog's birthday.
Mein Hund hat im April Geburtstag.
I don't like this voice. Just saying. It just sounds weird. Yeah, yeah. No thanks. So, listen up.
Mir leid, wir kommen nicht.
I'm sorry, we are not coming.
Hast du im April oder im Mai Geburtstag?
Is your birthday in April or in May?
Mein Sohn hat am 2. März Geburtstag.
My son's birthday is on the 2nd of March.
Wir kommen am 2. April.
We're coming on the 2nd of April. Wir kommen am 2. April. We're coming on the 2nd of April.
Leia, hast du am 4. Mai Geburtstag?
Leia, is your birthday on the 4th of May?
Ich habe am 3. März Geburtstag.
My birthday is on the 3rd of March.
Hast du am 3. April Geburtstag?
Is your birthday on the 3rd of April? Hast du am 3. April Geburtstag?
Mein Vater macht eine Party und meine Tante kommt.
Okay. My father is... Wait.
Macht.
Have it.
Macht.
It's not is having, because that means... Oh, also, thank you BlackBerry and hello. But yeah, I am rant here. The German part of macht eine Party. The word for word translation is having a party. It's not the right one. Because it actually is making. Because, hey, you if you're... You can make a party, be the host, or you're having a party. Which is actually technically the same, but in this sentence, is making is more like the appropriate translation for it. So, yeah. So, not we're having a party. Yes. Having a party, and my aunt is coming. And yeah. My father is making a party, and my aunt is coming.
Wir machen am 4. Mai eine Party, kommst du?
Okay, we are having a party on the 4th of May. Are you coming?
Wir machen am 3. Mai eine Party. Machen eine Party am 3. Mai.
We're making a party on the 3rd of May. Okay. And hello, Billy. How's it going? And, Duolingo, technically you're right, but also you're wrong. Because how I did it is actually the same. Because, hey, you emphasized... There's a party on the 3rd of May, okay? But you say, yeah, on the 3rd of May, we have a party. I mean, your translation is more like, yeah, on this date, there's a party. But this is more like, okay, we are doing this on this date, day, which is, in my opinion, more important because then the person knows, oh, okay. Because you can split this up in two sentences. The first one, wir machen eine Party. We are having a party. Question to that, when is the party? On the 3rd of May. Your Lego store resolution. You first asked them, hey, are you free on the 3rd of May? And they ask, yeah, probably, why? And then you say, yeah, we're making a party. And yeah, Billy, I'm good, like always. Yeah. And also, rent this over with this. What are you doing on the 4th of April? Was machst du am 4. April?
Meine Frau macht am 3. April eine Party.
Okay, my wife is having a party on the 3rd of April. Okay.
Die Party ist am 2. Mai.
The party is on the 2nd of May. Die Party ist am 2. Mai. Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Ich mache eine Party und meine Freunde kommen.
I'm making a party and my friends are coming. Ich mache eine Party und meine Freunde kommen. My friends are coming, yep. Still the same.
Meine Party ist am 2. Mai.
My party is on the 2nd of March. Meine Party ist am 2. Mai. Hello?
Ich möchte am 4. April eine Party machen.
I want to make a party on the 4th of April. Ich möchte am 4. April eine Party machen. I would like to have a party on the 4th of April. My transition is technically, it's the same. It's the same sentence, but structured differently. Because I find it's more important to... Okay, babe. Actually, no, I never mind. Never mind. I'll be making a party on the 3rd of March. Because you're saying, okay, there's something important on a day. Okay, we know what it is, but when is it? On the 3rd of May, March. Duolingo probably says, yeah, about that actually. And you actually say, oh, okay. What's it mean? Duolingo wants to say, yeah, you mean you want to have on the 3rd of May is something important. Okay, what is important? A party. I mean, ich mache am 3. März eine Party. I'm having a party on the 3rd of March.
Wir machen am 3. Mai eine Party.
Hold off. Was ist das? The one that I just... Wait.
Wir machen am 3. Mai eine Party. Machen am 3. Mai eine Party.
We're making a party on the 3rd of May. Excuse me. Or I'm
just... Wann ist das Picknick?
Oh. When is the picnic? Ooh.
Hat deine Mutter am 10. März Geburtstag?
Yeah. Is the birthday of your mother on... Is on the 10th of March your mother's birthday? Is your mother... still the same. Structurally, it's different, but the meaning is still the same. Here, your question first. Okay, it's something important. Okay, when is this important thing? On the 10th of March. My structure is, okay, something is important on the 10th of March. Okay, what is important on the 10th of March? It's your mother's birthday. Because then you connect the date with the thing and not the thing with the date, because that is sometimes okay, for me personally, not the best way to remember dates, because I think, okay, when is again your mother's birthday? I completely forgot. This way I remember, okay. 10th of March, your mother's birthday. Got it.
Wir machen am 1. Mai ein Picknick.
We're having a picnic on the 1st of May. This is my sentence, okay? Wir machen am 1. Mai ein Picknick.
Wir machen am 10. Juli eine Party.
We're making a party on the 2nd, on the 10th of July. Party on the 10th of July. Yet the Cookie Man, this is the name. This is the name of the stream that, a cooking stream that I will do when this is full. And when this is, when this challenge has, is finished, I will be, I don't know when exactly I'm doing that cooking stream. Probably on the weekends. I don't know. On the weekend, probably. Again, I don't know if it's, I think with tomorrow the it's completely finished this challenge. So I don't know if this month or next month. Just saying. I promise I will do a cooking stream. But when it's when this cooking stream is happening, I can't promise that completely.
Wir machen am 7. Juli ein Picknick.
We are having a picnic on the 7th of July.
Meine Mutter hat am 7. Juli Geburtstag.
My mother's birthday is on the 17th of July. Meine Mutter hat am 7. Juli Geburtstag.
Ich mache morgen eine Party. Kannst du kommen?
I am having or having a party tomorrow. Can you come? Ah, okay. 97%. Oh boy. Or basically just 900 points more. So if somebody has some 900 points, go for it. I will do a cooking stream. When? I don't know yet. But I will, but it will happen. It will happen. Oh, maybe to Christmas. Huh. Some cooking stream. I could make a baking stream too. It's for me, technically cooking, baking. It's technically it's the same. I know it's different things, but cooking and bake. I mean, I could bake some cookies. Maybe make some soup. I don't know. Probably some cookies. I mean, some good army cookies, which probably don't look that good. I mean, making two streams. I could maybe make a 12-hour stream. The first half is making lunch making just a normal meal and then later bake some cookies. Ha! Yeah, that's probably what I'm gonna do. Especially because when I finish with the cookies, I will definitely post the picture on Twitter. And maybe also on, and also probably on the Discord. And for those people who want to join, exclamation mark Discord. There's the link to the Discord server if you haven't joined yet. And yeah, continuing.
Danke, ich kann am 7. Juli kommen.
Okay, thank you. I can come on the 7th of July.
Good. Wir machen ein Picknick, kannst du kommen?
We're having a picnic. Can you come? Can you come? Do we all come? Does everybody come? This could technically be taken out of context. Everybody can make clips if you want. There's no problem. Especially because the more clips I have, the more I can make a clip compilation video. Anyway. Wir machen ein Picknick. Kannst du kommen? We are having a picnic. Can you come?
Ich mache eine Party. Kannst du kommen?
Okay.
Ich. Mache eine Party. Kannst du kommen?
I'm having a party. Can you come? I mean, can you all come? I mean, I don't know what's down there, but can you come? Okay, that joke. Sorry. Just sorry. It was just out of proportion. Anyway.
Machst du ein Picknick?
Are you having a picnic? Or are you making a picnic? Because that's definitely the right sentence.
Yeah. Ich kann kommen.
Yes, I can come. I'm too corrupt already. How about from the internet with that? Oh, well, damn, it's easy. There should be a little symbol that looks like a... It looks like one of those movie things. Wait. Wait. Yeah, it looks like one of those things. Just click on that. If you save it, please give it a name, because all the ones that don't have a name will get deleted after every stream. Just saying so. Please, if you make a clip, name it. Doesn't matter if you're doing it on mobile or... Yeah. And... Yeah. Basically, if you make a clip, please name it. And yeah. So, what is your final decision? Wait. Oh, I completely forgot that. I really completely forgot that we had that. Look, do you want to have the interview after the stream, or maybe tomorrow if you want? You just don't want to, or don't want to become a new elite member. Because, yeah, that's the last thing. And, the decision, again, I will decide it after the interview. So, yeah. Anyway. So. Ja, ich kann kommen. Yes, I can come to the interview. For example. Okay.
Kannst du morgen kommen?
Can you come tomorrow?
Wir machen am 4. Juli ein Picknick.
We are making a picnic on the 4th of July. Which is probably good. If you live in the US. I mean, technically you can also make a picnic, have a picnic on the 4th of July anywhere in the world, but probably it's more important in the US because of the Independence Day. Wir machen am 4. Juli ein Picknick.
So. Ja, ich kann morgen kommen.
Yes, I can come tomorrow. Ja, ich kann morgen kommen.
Machst du am 7. März ein Picknick?
Are you having a picnic on the 7th of March? Machst du am 7. März ein Picknick?
Du machst morgen eine Party und ich kann kommen.
You are making a party tomorrow and I can come. Du machst morgen eine Party und ich kann kommen.
Hat deine Mutter am 10. März Geburtstag?
Is your... Is your mother's birthday on the 10th of March?
Wir machen am 10. Juli eine Party.
Thank you, Gilgal. Okay. We are having a party on the 10th of July. continue. So, that's number 4.
Kannst du zur Party kommen?
Can you come to the party?
Hallo, hier ist deine Einladung.
Hello. Here is your invitation.
Hast du eine Einladung für mich?
Do you have an invitation for me? For mich. Okay. Ron, you just went into Deutsch. Or Denglish, technically. Which is the German word which describes an English word used in German. That was timing. I mean, I like timing. Anyway. Hast du eine Einladung für mich?
Ja. Danke, wir kommen auf jeden Fall.
Thank you or thanks. We are definitely coming.
Ali und Max, kommt ihr am Samstag zur Party?
Ali and Max, are you coming to the party on Saturday?
Duo und Mia, kommt ihr zur Party oder nicht? Kommt ihr zur Party oder nicht?
Duo and Mia, are you coming to the party or not?
Tim und Kurt, macht ihr ein Picknick?
Tim and Kurt, are you having a picnic?
Isabella und Anna, möchtet ihr zur Party kommen?
Isabella and Anna. Do you like to come? Would you like to? Like to come to the party.
Vielen Dank, wir kommen auf jeden Fall.
Thank you, we're definitely coming. Vielen Dank, wir kommen auf jeden Fall. The more I hear the word kommen, the more I think this is more like an orgy of something and...
Max und Alex, wir machen eine Party, kommt ihr?
Max... And Alex, we are having a party. Are you coming? Really, that's also the reason why I don't say common. that much in German because, or in English, because I'm already too much character from the internet that I just, every time I hear this word, I just immediately went, oh yeah, which is orgasm. And yeah, that is a problem. Just saying.
Oh. Here is the Einladung. Kommst du zur Party?
Here's the invitation. Are you coming to the party? Here's the Einladung. Kommst du zur Party?
Nina und Max, möchtet ihr kommen?
Nina and Max, would you like to come?
Ja, ich möchte auf jeden Fall kommen.
Yes, I would like to come. Ja, ich möchte auf jeden Fall kommen. Yes, I would definitely like to come.
Mark und Karl, möchtet ihr ins Kino gehen?
Mark and Karl, would you like to go to the cinema? Mark und Karl, möchtet ihr ins Kino gehen? Okay, would you like to go to the movie together?
Du und Lisa, macht ihr am Wochenende eine Party?
Du und Lisa, are you having a party on the weekend? Du und Lisa, macht ihr am Wochenende eine Party? Karl, Tim und Kurt, are you having a picnic?
Tim und Kurt, macht ihr ein Picknick?
Max und Alex, we are having a party, are you coming? Could you not be that fishing depressed?
Und Alex.
Or just sarcastic at all?
Wir machen eine Party. Möchtet ihr kommt? Kommt ihr?
Okay, so number 5. The gift. Wonderful gift. A present, actually.
Das Geschenk.
Which is actually the German word for present. Making somebody a gift. Okay, yeah, but if you just say das Geschenk, then you mean the present. Or, yeah, the gift.
Hallo Maria und Tim. Feiert ihr meinen Geburtstag?
Hello, Maria and Tim. Are you celebrating my birthday?
Hallo, Freunde, könnt ihr kommen?
Hello, friends. Can you come? The more I said like that, it gets more dangerous.
Hannah und Max, könnt ihr ein Geschenk kaufen?
Hannah and Max, could you buy a present? Or a gift? I guess.
Geschenk.
Hannah und Max, könnt ihr ein Geschenk kaufen?
Ich bin im Restaurant. Kommt ihr, Maria und du?
Okay. I am at the restaurant. Are you coming, du and Maria? Maria and du.
Tim, möchtet ihr zu Hause essen?
Max and Tim, would you like to eat at home?
Wir möchten im Restaurant essen.
We would like to eat at the restaurant. I mean, I'm speaking German since I was born because I'm, and I'd like to say this, I was born, raised and live currently in Austria. And I would like to move away to another country. But at the same time, Austria is a beautiful country. And yeah, it's weird. So speaking German is for me like normal because, well, the thing is, My Germany is not like the normal German you hear like from people from Germany. It's more like a different version. It's like Bavarian German. Some kind. It's its own thing though. I call it also the Austrian German, not Bavarian German. Because, for example, the best example actually is how you say potatoes in Austria. In normal German, you have... No. I know that happened. But don't say it like that. Because that could mean something really bad. Yeah. Sorry, BlackBerry, but... yeah. Best example for Austrian and difference between Austrian German and normal German is potatoes. In normal German, you say Kartoffel for a potato. In Austria, you could also say Erdäpfel, which, if you translate it completely exactly like that, it's more like earth apple. I mean, potato. You would like some earth apple? Or tomato. Tomato is the weirdest. Because you have paradise here in Austria. Well, there's no English equivalent unless you mean like paradising something. The paradiser. If you eat it, you are going to the paradise or something. Doesn't matter what religion you are or even if you've done really bad. And could go to hell, but yeah. I really wonder why do we Austrians say Paradeiser to tomatoes? I mean, you can also say tomate like every other German, but yeah. Also, weird trivia from to whoever makes the wiki page. On a VTuber wiki, trivia here. I learned my way how I speak German. It's not from learning it normally from school. No, actually from learning it through watching TV, because I mostly watch the TV channels from Germany. So yeah, that's why I speak German like that. Anyway, the sentence "Wir möchten im Restaurant essen" is "We would like to eat at a restaurant." Wir möchten im Restaurant essen.
Die Party ist zu Hause, nicht im Park.
Okay, the party is at home. Not at the park. Ah, good.
Ich feiere meinen Geburtstag im Restaurant.
I am celebrating my birthday at the restaurant. By the way, little something. Yeah, I have to. Benjamin the Elephant, really? That's the English version? The English name? But yeah, I, not gonna lie, one thing I would like is to eat this fishing cake. I don't know why, but I'm 23. And one of my favorite things I want to eat is this fishing cake. Exactly this cake. Not, I don't know if it's from the same thing, but, or that too, but I would like to eat this cake. Just because. I know, according to many people, it's actually not that bad, good, but I don't care. I want to eat this. And really, 20 years, 23 years, and I've never ate this cake. And let me tell you, this is now a promise here. I will, for my next birthday, I will stream. I'll make it on a, okay, I can say it. I plan on a 24-hour stream, and yeah. But this is, I think I will eat this cake on stream. Not during a break, or no. I will make it before the stream starts, and then eat it during the stream. You know, it's probably then also ruined, but I don't care. I want to eat that cake. Even though, as I said, many people don't like that cake and say the cake is not that very good, but I don't care. It's one of my childhood dreams, okay? Anyway. Also, another childhood dream of mine was that me, my family, and all my friends meet up at the local restaurant that's not far away from where I live on a Sunday evening, Sunday evening to have a little chat, have a little enjoyable evening to talk and so on. This is really something. This is also a childhood dream. And another thing is also, I would even go to the when I die. And before I die, I will write into my testament that all my friends, all my family members meet up at that restaurant and have an enjoyable Sunday evening. Only after they are doing that, they can get all the other stuff, probably. This is the only requirement. This will really happen. Maybe if I really die and have to give everybody something, then one requirement is they have an enjoyable Sunday evening at that restaurant. And if they don't have this enjoyable evening, then they don't get anything. And I mean, really, they're not like, oh yeah, I'm here, and they just go, no. Also, everybody should come into to have this wonderful, enjoyable evening, or else nobody gets it. Nobody. Again, this is the requirement then on my testament. Anyway.
Carlos und Ali, könnt ihr Wein bestellen?
Carlos and Ali, could you buy some wine? Carlos und Ali, könnt ihr Wein bestellen? Or can you order wine?
Bestellen.
Order? I mean, yeah, order is technically... Okay, this is something weird, because in German, you could... Bestellen is sometimes... You can also buy it, but no. But yeah, order is... You order it. From Amazon, probably. Even though it's not secret. Or from a local... supermarket.
Ich brauche ein Geschenk für meinen Vater.
I need a present or gift for my father. Fast!
Alex und Max, feiert ihr einen Geburtstag im Juli?
Alex and Max, are you celebrating a birthday in July? Alex und Max, feiert ihr einen Geburtstag im Juli?
Mein Hund feiert meinen Geburtstag zu Hause. Mein Hund feiert meinen Geburtstag zu Hause. Mein Hund feiert meinen Geburtstag zu Hause.
Okay, my dog is celebrating my birthday at home. Okay. Why are you not taking your dog with you? Unless it's a party at the bar, then okay, understandable. But Hey. Dogs are humans' best friend, so why are you not why are you not good to your dog there? My brain just came up with something completely weird, and I will not say it because technically it's wrong. And I will not say why. Because it will definitely just take away why.
Meine Mutter spricht Türkisch und sie lernt Englisch.
My mother speaks Turkish and studies English. When you say that I should put a she in there, then let me tell you, this is still the same sentence. Okay, good. Thank you.
Mia und du könnt ihr zur Party im Park kommen?
Mia and du, can you come at the party? No. Come to the party at the park.
Wir feiern meinen Geburtstag zusammen.
We're celebrating my birthday together. Like this year. And thank you, Blackberry, for the water. Wir feiern meinen Geburtstag zusammen. Lucas and Max, are you celebrating a birthday at the park?
Lucas. Und Max, feiert ihr einen Geburtstag im Park?
Okay. Hello, Maria and Tim. Are you celebrating my birthday?
Hallo, Maria und Tim. Feiert ihr meinen Geburtstag?
The way you say it, I would definitely imagine that this girl is just doing this. Because if you mean like what you wrote there with this one guy that has done some pretty bad stuff in the past and is not alive anymore, thank God, then that is a part of the sensitive topics, and according to the rules, no. Yes. No. And yeah, anyway, what I wanted to say there. This girl definitely just would really just call Maria and Tim and just ask them that, because she's so lonely. Or Angela's probably also, I don't know. Anyway. Yay, we have finished our birthday. Now we have hobbies too, health and people. And I would like to take a little break. Okay, so see you in a few minutes.
Eine junge Dame in sehr aufreizender Unterwäsche aus der Wohnung. Du hast gerade die Pizza ihrer Mitbewohnerin gegeben. Und sie kniet sich vor dir hin. Und strullt vor dir auf den Boden und hält dabei die ganze Zeit den Augenkontakt. Dann steht sie auf, verbeugt sich und redet mit dir. Da gehst du doch nicht in die Wohnung!
Well, actually... Yeah? I'm Mion. Yeah? Orca. Ich habe gerade auf einer sehr dummen Sache gerade das gepausiert. Naja. Only I have literally a lot of songs planned. Not a, that a lot, but a few. A lot. Right? So. A little bit of stretching for security reasons because... Oh. Please don't clip this. Please don't clip this sound. Yeah, it's also a VTuber. Ow! Ouch! Ouch! Yeah, that was Mountain.
I hope to make the popularity boom, breaking the barriers of gender, race, and negating our world's pesky gravity.
That right? Nein, der Napface. Ich mag das Napface. It just basically says, just. Aber um ehrlich zu sein, er ist schon einer der coolsten. Also nicht nur, weil er mich dann umbringen würde, sondern größtenteils, weil wenn er einfach also, wenn er nicht mal versuchen möchte, irgendwelche Syndiker zu töten oder einfach oder Oreos in Orangensaft tunkt, ist er schon ein netter Kerl und deswegen hat er auch etwas Cooles an sich. Ja, und deswegen, falls ihr irgendwas davon klippt und Yoshi sich schickt, bitte genau hier anhalten. Danke. Hilfe.
Nestlich.
Nestlich?
Nestlich.
Hört sich an wie Cerealien.
Die neuen Nestlich Frühstückscerealien.
Sag es in Haru-Stimme, dann ist er besser. Dann sieht es besser aus in meinem Stream. Meine in der Mimi-Stimme.
Die neuen Nestlich-Frühstücks-Cerealien, die schmecken wie Hundesohn und riechen auch danach.
Ist der Tisch zu hässlich und modern? Eventuell in morgen.
Meine Freunde haben einen Stuhl.
Das ist so. Meine Freunde haben einen Stuhl. So, I'm back. So, and we're doing some health. Now.
Bist du müde?
Are you tired?
Meine Katze ist krank.
My cat is sick.
Der Junge ist sehr müde.
Boy is very tired. Sorry. Der Junge ist sehr müde.
Ich habe nachts immer Hunger.
I am always hungry at night. I mean, a midnight snack is always something good. Anyway.
Bist du traurig?
Are you sad?
Ich bin krank.
I'm sick. Ich bin krank.
Hast du Durst?
Are you thirsty?
Ich esse manchmal zu viel.
I eat too much. Yeah, sometimes.
Ich habe keinen Durst. Ich habe keinen Durst.
I'm not thirsty. Also, a little health tip. Technically a little health tip you could say from me. If you're feeling hungry, always drink a glass of water. Because sometimes if you're feeling hungry, then it could also be that you're thirsty. Because the feeling of being hungry and being thirsty is exactly the same. So yeah, that's always why I say, what is good for your health and your sanity?
Ich schlafe nicht gut.
I don't sleep well.
Bist du krank?
Bist du krank? Are you sick?
Ich habe nachts immer Durst.
I'm always trembling at night. It would be a interesting thing. Yeah, I don't know, but always at night, I'm always trembling. I'm sorry, what? Almost first at night. I mean, you could also be Austria at night. Or friends. I mean, not French. I mean, like, your friends. Your friends. Okay.
Ich bin sehr traurig.
I'm very sad. Ich bin sehr traurig. My grandma passed away. I could say something, but nope.
Mein Bett ist nicht bequem und ich schlafe nicht viel.
My bed is not comfortable and I'm sleeping. I don't sleep that well. Mein Bett ist nicht bequem und ich schlafe nicht viel. My bed is not is uncomfortable and I don't sleep much.
Bequem, nicht.
Uncomfortable, nicht bequem, uncomfortable, not comfortable, stay. Don't sleep much, yeah.
Ich habe Durst.
I'm thirsty. Ich habe Durst.
Ich schlafe nachts nicht und ich bin jetzt müde.
That's telling me this night. I don't sleep at night and now I'm tired. Ich schlafe nachts nicht und ich bin jetzt müde.
Ich bin traurig und ich schlafe zu viel.
Okay, what? I'm sad and I sleep too much. I mean, I don't know exactly how to feel about this sentence. Ich bin traurig und ich schlafe zu viel.
Ich esse manchmal zu viel.
I sometimes eat too much. Das ist Nummer 2. Der Hospital. Das Krankenhaus.
Das Krankenhaus.
And I just remembered this one video about how to pronounce words in German. I mean, like, Hospital. Hospital in English. And the German guy just goes, Das Krankenhaus. Which, again, you only have this aggressive German if you are aggressive or angry. If you're having a normal, nice, calm conversation, you don't need to say in German, ja, ich gehe heute ins Krankenhaus. I mean, you could just say, ja, ich gehe heute ins Krankenhaus. I mean, it's the same, but if you are saying it too aggressively, then the other one just goes, what the fudge is wrong with you? If you go to the hospital, please, hopefully it's a checkup, because don't say hospital that aggressively. Unless you're really right now angry at something for some reason, even though in the beginning you sounded like everything is normal.
Mein Sohn hat Kopfschmerzen.
My son has a headache. It could also be a migraine. Which I thought always it's the same, but actually it's not.
Du musst ins Krankenhaus gehen.
You have to go to the hospital. Du musst ins Krankenhaus gehen.
Robert, trink heute Abend nur Tee.
Robert? Only drink tea this evening. Because drink only tea this evening, yeah. Same sentence, same meaning.
Anna, geh ins Krankenhaus, bitte.
Anna, go to the hospital, please.
Ich habe Kopfschmerzen.
That's a little weird. I have a headache, yeah! Ich habe Kopfschmerzen. You don't be so happy when you have a headache. Well, unless you have some weird... Unless your personality is somehow that weird.
Du bist krank, du geh zum Arzt.
You are sick, Duo. Go to the doctor. For one second I thought I wanted to make the joke. Duo, you're drunk, go home.
Ich brauche eine Tablette, bitte.
If you say it like that, then yeah, definitely, because you sound a bit out of breath. I need a pill, please.
Du bist müde und traurig, geh zum Arzt.
Maybe it's a fetish? I mean... Maybe? Okay.
Du bist müde und traurig, geh zum Arzt.
Okay.
Du bist müde und traurig, geh zum Arzt.
You're tired and sad. Go to the doctor, because... Probably you probably have clinical depression. I can't confirm that though. Because hey, I'm not a doctor.
Mila, du bist krank, ist nur Suppe.
Mila, you are sick. Only eat soup. Eat only soup. Same meaning.
Ich bin müde und ich habe Kopfschmerzen.
I'm tired and I have a headache. Ich bin müde und ich habe Kopfschmerzen.
Wo ist das Krankenhaus?
Where is the hospital? Well, it's right over there. Down the street and then on the third street on the right.
Angela, heißt es heute keine Pizza?
Angela, don't eat pizza today. I mean, pizza is good, okay? Angela, iss heute keine Pizza.
Ich muss zum Arzt gehen.
I have to go to the doctor.
Brauchst du eine Tablette?
Do you need a pill? Brauchst du eine Tablette? So, do you have a pill?
Hast du eine Tablette?
Yeah. Mila, don't drink milk, please.
Mila, trink keine Milch, bitte.
I mean, because probably she's lactose intolerant. Lesson number 3. What is 16? Well, it's 16. 16. 17.
17.
Guten Morgen. Mein Name ist Katharina Baum.
Excuse me, what did you just say?
Guten Morgen. Mein Name ist Katharina Baum.
I don't know, but this is weird for me. Oh, am I? Especially because she says morning, like, oh yeah, good morning. My name is Katharina Baum. Also good that you didn't just say Baum to tree there. Good morning, my name is Katharina Baum. And yeah, name.
Herr Brecht, haben Sie einen Termin?
Mr. Brecht, do you have an appointment?
Um wie viel Uhr können Sie kommen?
At what time can you come?
Herr Jones, Ihr Termin ist um 17 Uhr.
Mr. Jones, your appointment is at 17:00 Jones, your appointment is at 17:00. Yeah, of course, Robert, if you think about it, there's no, but my brain.
Guten Morgen, wie ist Ihr Name?
Good morning, what is your name? Guten Morgen, wie ist Ihr Name?
Guten Morgen, möchten Sie einen Termin machen?
Okay. Good morning. Would you like to make an appointment?
Guten Tag, wie ist Ihr Name?
Guten Tag, wie ist Ihr Name? Good afternoon, what is your name?
Mein Termin ist um 16 Uhr.
My appointment is at 4:00.
Ich bin krank, ich muss einen Termin machen.
I'm sick, I have to make an appointment. Ich bin krank, ich muss einen Termin machen.
Hallo, mein Name ist Robert Musel.
Hallo, my name is Robert Musel.
Um wie viel Uhr möchten Sie einen Termin machen?
Okay.
Um wie viel Uhr möchten Sie einen Termin machen?
At what time would you like to make the appointment?
Frau Merkel, Ihr Termin ist um 16 Uhr.
Merkel, your appointment, Miss Merkel, your appointment is at 4:00. Frau Merkel, Ihr Termin ist um 16 Uhr.
Ich möchte einen Termin machen.
I would like to make an appointment. Ich möchte einen Termin machen.
Frau Graf, ist Ihr Termin um 17 Uhr?
Mrs. Graf, is your appointment at 5:00? Frau Graf, ist Ihr Termin um 17 Uhr?
Um wie viel Uhr ist Ihr Termin?
At what time is your appointment? Um wie viel Uhr ist Ihr Termin? What time is your appointment now?
Herr Jones, Ihr Termin ist um 17 Uhr.
Mr. Jones, your appointment is at 5:00.
Um wie viel Uhr ist Ihr Termin?
Um wie viel Uhr ist Ihr Termin? Sometimes I hate to online call. Just sometimes. Auf, no matter. I can't speak. But you just did.
Mein Sohn hat Bauchschmerzen.
My son has a stomachache.
Frau Benz, können Sie nicht sprechen?
Oh, Mrs. Benz. Can't you speak? Frau Behrens, können Sie nicht sprechen? Can you not speak?
Ja, ich habe Fieber.
Yes, I have a fever.
Herr Graf, Sie müssen Tee trinken.
Mr. Graf, you have to drink tea.
Ich habe Bauchschmerzen und ich kann nicht essen.
Understandable. I have a stomachache and I can't eat. Ich habe Bauchschmerzen und ich kann nicht essen.
Frau Schneider, Sie müssen im Bett bleiben.
Mrs. Schneider, you have to stay in bed.
Ich muss im Bett bleiben und schlafen.
I have to stay in bed and sleep.
Sie müssen zu Hause bleiben, Frau Merkel. Sie müssen zu Hause bleiben, Frau Merkel.
You have to stay at your home, Mrs. Merkel. Because we currently have a pandemic. Sorry.
Ich habe Bauchschmerzen.
I have a stomachache. Ich habe Bauchschmerzen.
Haben Sie Fieber, Frau Williams?
Do you have a fever, Mrs. Williams?
Ich kann nicht sprechen.
I can't speak. Ich kann nicht sprechen.
Haben Sie Bauchschmerzen, Herr Macron?
Do you have a stomachache, Mr. Macron?
Ich habe Fieber und ich kann nicht sprechen.
I have a fever and I can't speak. Ich habe Fieber und ich kann nicht sprechen.
Können Sie nachts gut schlafen, Herr Kohl?
Can you sleep well at night, Mr. Cole? Können Sie nachts gut schlafen, Mr. Cole? Oh, Hartmut. You have to drink water, Mrs. Schiller. Okay.
Sie müssen Wasser trinken, Frau Schiller.
Yeah, I have to stay in bed and sleep. Okay.
Ich muss im Bett bleiben und schlafen.
Ja. Yay. Can you? And the last lesson.
Ich bin glücklich.
You don't sound like that. I am happy.
Schade, gute Besserung.
Too bad. Feel better?
Besserung.
Well, that is a thing again with because this is what
Besserung.
Because this is what Duolingo thinks because of feeling better. But normally what I got is actually that you say get well. So basically you can say too bad, get well.
Du bist krank, gute Besserung.
You're sick, get well. Du bist krank, gute Besserung.
Ich habe keine Zahnschmerzen und ich bin glücklich.
I mean, I would also be happy if I don't have a toothache. I don't have a toothache and I am happy.
Mein Mann hat keine Kopfschmerzen mehr.
My husband doesn't have a headache anymore.
Oh nein, gute Besserung.
Oh no, get well. Oh nein, gute Besserung.
Hurra, du bist gesund.
Hooray, you are healthy.
Gesund.
Ich bin glücklich, mein Sohn hat kein Fieber mehr.
I'm happy. My son doesn't have a fever anymore. Ich bin glücklich. Mein Sohn hat kein Fieber mehr.
Hurra, du hast keine Kopfschmerzen. Du hast keine Kopfschmerzen mehr.
Hooray, you don't have a headache anymore.
Hier ist eine Suppe. Gute Besserung.
Here is a soup. Get well.
Hurra, ich bin gesund und so glücklich.
Hooray, I'm healthy and happy. Hurra, ich bin gesund und so glücklich. And so happy. Yep.
Meine Tochter hat keine Zahnschmerzen mehr.
I wanted to click on me. My daughter doesn't have a toothache anymore.
Du bist gesund und ich bin glücklich.
You're healthy and I'm happy. Du bist gesund und ich bin glücklich.
Danke, ich habe keine Zahnschmerzen mehr.
Thank you. I don't have a toothache anymore.
Hurra, meine Oma ist jetzt gesund.
Hooray, my grandma is now healthy. Hurra, meine Oma ist jetzt gesund.
Hurra, ich habe keine Kopfschmerzen mehr.
Hooray, I don't have a headache anymore. Hurra, ich habe keine Kopfschmerzen mehr.
Hurra, du hast jetzt keine Zahnschmerzen.
Hooray, you don't have a toothache. Hurra, du hast keine Zahnschmerzen.
Hurra, du hast keine Kopfschmerzen. Du hast keine Kopfschmerzen.
Yeah. And we're finished with health. Thank you very much. So, Hobbies.
Kannst du surfen?
Can you surf?
Wir gehen morgen tanzen.
We are dancing. We are going dancing tomorrow.
Morgen. Tanzen. Gehen.
I don't know, but this sentence feels weird to me.
Wir surfen oft.
We surf always. Or sometimes. Often. Yeah. Wir surfen oft. We surf often. I jog every morning.
Ich jogge jeden Morgen.
Welche Hobbys hast du?
Which?
Welche?
What? Does it fit more? What? Which hobbies do you have? Or what hobbies do you have?
Deine Freunde sind nett.
Your friends are nice.
Kannst du tanzen?
Can you dance? Kannst du tanzen?
Mein Bruder tanzt manchmal zu Hause.
My brother dances sometimes at home. Yep, my brother dances sometimes at home. My brother sometimes dances at home. It's still the same.
Tanzt du gern?
Do you like to dance, baby?
Meine Hobbys kosten kein Geld.
My hobbies cost no money. What for hobbies? Almost. Never mind what I wanted to say there. Meine Hobbys kosten kein Geld. Cost no money.
Kannst du für mich Gitarre spielen?
Can you play guitar for me?
Meine Freunde tanzen gern. Meine Freunde tanzen gern.
My friends like to dance.
Tanzt du oft am Wochenende?
Do you dance often at the weekend? Tanzt du oft am Wochenende?
Möchtest du tanzen?
Would you like to dance, my dear? That's all right.
Wir gehen später surfen.
We are going to surf later. Wir gehen später surfen.
Deine Gitarre ist alt.
Your guitar is old. I mean, unless it... If it's still playable, then it's still good. Deine Gitarre ist alt. Okay, I'm playing guitar this evening. You are dancing.
Ich. Spiele, Gitarre und du.
Oh. Okay.
Heute Abend und du tanzt.
Ich spiele heute Abend Gitarre und du tanzt. So. This sounds like you would like to make a band with him. Ne? My friends like to dance.
Meine Freunde tanzen gern.
Yep. Okay. Number two. The violin.
Die Geige.
Die Geige. The movie.
Der Film.
Yeah.
Ich mag den Film nicht.
I don't like that. I don't like the movie. Okay.
Tim und Ali, spielt ihr Geige oder Klavier?
Tim and Ali, do you play violin or piano?
Max und Nina, habt ihr heute Zeit?
Max and Nina, do you have time today?
Markus und Maria, habt ihr zu Hause ein Klavier? Markus und Maria, habt ihr ein Klavier zu Hause?
Wait.
Markus und Maria, habt ihr zu Hause ein Klavier?
Okay.
Zu Hause ein Klavier.
Markus und Maria, do you have a piano at home?
Ich kann kein Instrument spielen.
I can't play an instrument.
Mia und Markus, I mean, spielt ihr Tennis?
Mia and Markus, do you play tennis?
Spielst du ein Instrument?
Do you play an instrument? Spielst du ein Instrument? Well, I don't, sadly.
Ich mag Fußball. Möchtest du ein Spiel sehen?
Unless it's the triangle. Anyway, okay. I like soccer. Would you like to watch a match?
Carlos und Alex, habt ihr einen Volleyball?
Carlos und Alex, do you have a volleyball? Carlos und Alex, habt ihr einen Volleyball?
Tom und Karl, spielt ihr am Wochenende Tennis?
Tom and Carl, do you play tennis on the weekend?
Duo, möchtest du einen Film sehen?
Duo, would you like to watch a movie? Duo, möchtest du einen Film sehen?
10, 9, 8.
10, 9, 8, okay.
Wir möchten am Sonntag Tennis spielen.
We would like to play Tennis on Sunday. Wir möchten am Sonntag Tennis spielen.
Spielst du Geige oder Gitarre?
Do you play the violin or guitar? Spielst du Geige oder Gitarre? Okay. I can't play an instrument.
Ich kann kein Instrument spielen.
Okay. I would like to watch a movie on the weekend.
Ich möchte einen Film am Wochenende sehen.
Yeah. Or I would like to watch a movie on the weekend.
Ich will wandern gehen, aber es regnet.
I want
will.
Want to. Want to go hiking, but it's raining.
Meine Mutter spielt sehr gern Videospiele.
Oh, nice. My mother likes to play video games.
Ich will heute Gitarre spielen. Ich will heute Gitarre spielen.
I would like to play the guitar today.
Willst du ins Restaurant gehen?
So, do you want to go to the restaurant?
Meine Katze hört nicht gern Podcasts.
Excuse me, what the fish did you just say there? My cat doesn't like to listen to podcasts. What kind of podcasts are you listening to?
Willst du morgen joggen gehen?
I mean, there are some good ones. I don't listen to podcasts because... But there are some good ones out there. Can I recommend some of them? I could, but I don't. I mean, it's easy. Just Google. Just look up and then... Anyway, would you like to jog tomorrow? Willst du morgen joggen gehen? You want to go jogging tomorrow?
Mein Bruder hört gern Jazz.
Oh, my brother likes to listen to jazz. I'm sorry, what? My brother likes to listen to jazz. You like jazz?
Ali und Lukas, warum hört ihr nicht gern Jazz?
Excuse me, what? Ali and Lukas. Why don't you like to listen to jazz? Because probably they don't like it at all. Or they just like something else. I mean, everybody has their favorite genre, music genre. So, yeah. Some people just like everything, like me. And some people just like specific things and don't like specific genres. Again, everybody is open there. And asking that is more like, yeah, you would like to hurt them just because they don't like jazz. And I would hurt you because you want to hurt them. And they don't like jazz.
Willst du später Basketball spielen?
Nein, that's Blackberry. Willst du später would you like to play basketball later? Willst du später Basketball spielen? I mean, understandable, but also I also like folklore music sometimes. There's some good ones out there, and also it depends on, again, mostly I like songs when they're a banger.
Ich will ins Kino gehen.
Like, for example, I had for many weeks a song stuck in my head about the robot that has nearly learned every human feeling except for one, and that is the feeling of sending a picture of his stick, which is my little cover word for a specific thing, for the male genitalia, and send it to strangers on the internet. Like, I was stuck in my hand. I was so much stuck in my head that I want, when I do another concert stream, I will sing this song And from the same artist also another song that's just named HYCYBH. That is just an acronym for something. Because that song is just good. It was also the first one that I listened to of this artist. I mean, he makes some good songs. They're a real banger. If you just listen to the melody, it's just really so, yeah, or something like that. But if you listen to the lyrics, you just go, excuse me, what the fish? For example, there's the song Mixed Messages. At first, you just go, okay, what does this mean exactly? Well, if you just listen to the song, you don't mind it. But if you learn the lyrics more, then you just notice, excuse me, okay, at first it's about literally sending text to your girl or boyfriend. Then at some point you kick their dog. And after you pay the bill for the vet, it just continues with, oh yeah, by the way, I like to punch the stick of your dad. I just break that stick of your dad. Why? Really, if I said it already one time. My Spotify playlist is just, it's just weird. This is the Spotify playlist, and yeah, 936 songs. And holy fish, there are a lot. As you can see what songs there is. Also, that is the song, by the way, here, Mixed Messages. This is the song. Just listen to it. Just listen to the lyrics and just maybe even watch the video. Also, Fruit Salad is also a good song. And this is the one that I said before. HYCYBH. Do I want to say what it is? What about this song is? Well, I could. But just spoil everything. And yeah. Anyway, let's continue with this wonderful lesson of learning some German. Ich will ins Kino gehen. I want to go to the cinema.
Meine Oma spielt sehr gern Videospiele.
My grandma likes to play video games. Meine Oma spielt sehr gerne Videospiele. Okay, really likes it.
Max und Maria, hört ihr gern Jazz?
What is your fixation with Jazz now? Duolingo. Do you like the B-movie, probably? Max and Maria. Do you like jazz? Sorry.
Meine Frau hört nicht gern Podcasts.
My wife doesn't like to listen to podcasts. Podcasts. Meine Frau hört nicht gerne Podcasts.
Martin und Julia, hört ihr jeden Tag Jazz?
Okay, really, what is your fixation today with Jazz? Really, Duolingo, what is your fixation with that? And thanks, Gulliko, for the water. Martin and Julia. You like to listen to jazz every day. For the rest of your life. I mean, jazz is good. Jazz is good. It's really calm. House is also a good genre. Martin und Julia, hört ihr jeden Tag Jazz?
Meine Partnerin und ich hören nicht gern Podcasts.
My partner and I don't like to listen to podcasts. Okay. Meine Partnerin und ich hören nicht gerne Podcasts.
Peter und Anna, hört ihr oft Jazz?
Peter und Anna, do you listen to Jazz often? Peter und Anna, hört ihr oft Jazz? Okay, at this point I'd say it. Next time something weirdly is happening with Duolingo. I mean, I know, last time the $35 restaurant. Like, everything costs $35. Doesn't matter what it is. It always costs $35. And now, Jazz.
Mein Mann spielt sehr gern Videospiele.
My husband really likes to play video games. Mein Mann spielt sehr gerne Videospiele.
Meine Mutter spielt sehr gern Videospiele.
Anna really likes to play video games.
Willst du später Basketball spielen?
Willst du später Basketball spielen?
Meine Mutter spielt sehr gern Videospiele.
Likes to play video games. So. And just because I don't, because I'm afraid that there will be more jazz happening. How about ending this stream now? And I want to thank everybody who watched the highlight, and I will see you hopefully in the next episode. Your Nerman. And for everybody else, Okay. I just also want to thank you all for, well, being here for more Schumann. And let me look up who we can raid, who is right now live doing stuff. It's somebody really nice. Yeah. Okay, I will say it. I will rate you to Haruchikino, a dog girl, a German dog girl, human. Yeah, it's a German dog girl, and yeah, she's playing right now some Breath of the Wild modded. Just saying, and yeah, I will see you tomorrow to some Sonic horror games. And yeah, until then, you're Derman.